Dim, 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 dim. Taro, the light skin came on, baby. And here comes a flash. Here we go, and boom.
Yo, 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 what is going on, guys? This is Tyrogue here, aka the Light Skin Gamer, and I'm getting down with my all-time favorite game, Resident Evil 4, playing Mercenaries using Leon, but we are not here for the gameplay, my friends. We are here for the topic of the video, my thoughts on the Call of Duty Ghosts multiplayer reveal. And before I even get into this, this is a complete unbiased opinion and my thoughts on it, and I'm gonna let you guys know I'm not no Call of Duty fanboy, and can I see the bullshit that Call of Duty has been pulling over the years? Hell fucking yeah, I can see it. Call of Duty has been pulling bullshit like Modern Warfare 3, Black Ops 1. Well, Black Ops 1 multiplayer was bullshit. The zombies was the best part of Black Ops. Modern Warfare 2, that game was fun, but it was filled with bullshit. Basically, all the Call of Duty games before were filled with bullshit. And I can see it, though. But you can't take it away from the games. They were actually kind of fun. But anyway, let me actually get into this, okay? Basically, people have been saying stuff like, people that don't, oh, not that don't like Call of Duty, but just hate Call of Duty, or don't like it, or Battlefield fanboys that hate Call of Duty always say, Call of Duty's community shitty, which it is. The game doesn't change. It's the same shit over and over, and I can agree at that point in time, Modern Warfare 2 up until, well, Black Ops 2 kind of changed a little bit, but it still has the same gameplay mechanics. But Call of Duty Ghosts, real shit, it actually changed this year, and I'm actually happy. Let's clap it up. Yep, that's right. Let's clap it up for what we're talking about. Yeah, because Activision finally changed it up for once. Because if you look at Call of Duty Ghosts, and you look at Modern Warfare 2, and or if you even look at Black Ops 2, you notice a huge difference. Because I looked at it, I looked at the campaign reveal, and I was like, okay, they're doing the same shit. Because campaign reveal, you didn't see that many gameplay mechanics, you just saw how the environment looked. The environment looked okay, but there wasn't that many gameplay mechanics. But when I saw the multiplayer reveal, I damn near shit on myself, because literally, I was like, wow, they actually changed it. And then it was really that it actually kind of looked like Battlefield in a way. Like, they actually changed the graphics. They did say it was going to be the best looking Call of Duty game. But then again, it was played on Xbox One. I don't know how it looks on Xbox 360. It better not look like Modern Warfare 3 in HD. But I don't know, guys. I've not been excited for a Call of Duty game since Modern Warfare 2. Therefore, I actually want to get this one. But do I think the game is going to be perfect, or do I think the game is going to have any problems, or will it be flawless? Hell no, it won't be flawless, and of course it will have problems. Call of Duty games always have problems. You just need to figure out, they're not that huge problems. Like Black Ops 2, there was something wrong with the Dragonfire killstreak, there was something wrong with the FAL fully automatic, Noob Tombing, Modern Warfare 2, the Famas, and all. I can go on and on about what was wrong when the game first came out. Literally, when you buy a Call of Duty game, it's like beta testing. But they get on it, and I would have to say like probably a month. If people actually keep complaining about it a lot, they'll fix it. Possibly. But I don't know. I've never like sent in complaints straight to Infinity Ward or Treyarch, like, fix this shit or nothing like that. But I don't know. They usually do get on it. But anyway, let me actually talk about some of the features of the multiplayer that actually kind of did like hook me. Okay, ooh, messed up my mic for a minute. But, one mode that I actually really like is called Squads. It's like, oh yeah, before I even tell you about the squads, you can make your own fucking character. You can make up to 10 characters. Each character has 1 prestige, therefore 10 prestiges. And this links up into squads. You can pick one of your, you can go and you pick like 5 of your, soldiers that you made, and you can go into like, squad mode. You can play people offline, pay people online, or you can team up with your friends and do it. It's a pretty cool mode. Another mode is called Crank, which I think is actually pretty, well, I think it's good. They're trying to eliminate campers, and they're gonna do that in this one, maybe. But a 30 second window when you get your first kill, basically you get 1 kill, boom, you have 30 seconds to get another kill. If you don't do it, you will die. Now what if someone takes your kill and you keep getting your kills taken the whole time? That's gonna cause problems. That's one problem I can see already. Cause, yeah, I don't think people are gonna enjoy that much. But, I I thought it was a pretty good idea. But anyway, let me just keep on going. They said that they're putting in a bunch of new guns, which isn't unheard of in Call of Duty games. They always put in new guns. But the guns actually did hook me because they had three guns unhighlighted, which are guns we were familiar with. It was like the Vector, some, I think it was MK48, and some sniper rifle. But every other gun was like, apparently it's new. And I saw the way the guns look. I was like, oh, they look pretty cool. That's sweet. They brought back the M27, which I think it's cool, because I did like that in my Black Ops 2. But, let me get on these Battlefield fanboys for a minute, because I'm done talking about the features of it. And that's not even all the features, but I'm just going to get on these Battlefield fanboys, because this gameplay is running low. But, anyway, the Battlefield fanboys over the years have been giving Call of Duty shit, and I'm not going to just completely blame the fanboys for this. I think it's literally EA's fault for starting this bullshit. Because if you remember a Call of Duty, I think it was, if you remember a Battlefield commercial, or I think it was a, it wasn't a Medal of Honor commercial, it was a Battlefield commercial, I think. It said some shit like going above the call. Basically calling Call of Duty out. And all of their fanboys, well not, yeah, all their fanboys, fuck it, and or fans, whatever. Every one of them was just like, yeah, let's go kill Call of Duty, yeah, fuck Call of Duty. And they just hopped on this, like, never-ending fight to try to kill Call of Duty, and I hear this shit every single year. Oh, Call of Duty's dying. Call of Duty's gonna die this year. Just because you think Call of Duty's gonna die this year when there's fucking billions of people playing this shit, I don't think it's gonna die that fast, sir. And no, I'm not. I'm gonna clarify this again. I'm not a Call of Duty fanboy before anybody, like, I hate both. I hate any kind of fanboys, really, that are that negative. I'm not saying you can't, like, be a fan of a certain thing, but fanboys that just hate on other fans' games, this is not cool. Me personally, the whole Call of Duty versus Battlefield thing, I would rather have both. I have both right now. Battlefield 2, Battlefield Bad Company 2, Black Ops 2, and Modern Warfare 3, even though I don't fucking play Modern Warfare 3. But I have both. People just don't understand. You can't just be hooked to one game. You can have more than one. That's what some people don't understand. That's why I think that whole fanboy bullshit is so fucking stupid. But anyway, man, that's the end of this gameplay. I just whip out the shotgun and pop this bitch. And let me know what you guys think of the new Call of Duty Ghost reveal. And let me know what you guys think about both of these fanboys acting stupid. If you're new, hit that subscribe button. Thumbs it up. And that's it, guys. Tyroke is out.